Hello, hello, everybody. It is 1:02 p.m. Central Time on the 24th of June, 2020. Hope you're doing well. We are here in the United States still. It's Wednesday. Hope you're gonna get through the rest of the week. We're here to talk about seismic events that have struck since yesterday. Let's go ahead and just turn on a display capture. For those of you who are not aware, new 5.0 level activity has come rolling in down here in California. Near 6.0, 5.8. So 5.8 coming in here. This is significant size. And this is California, one day after our 7.4. And if you watched my update yesterday, you heard us issue our warning for right here. Talking about watching on California, well, that is definitely close enough, at least state-wise, on a forecast. But let's go get the info on this from the USGS. This is where we're going to start the update. Lone Pine, California. For those of you who live in California, you might already know what's at Lone Pine. But let me just go ahead and show everybody else on the planet. Lone Pine is a well-known area. It's a volcanic field, what we're getting ready to zoom in on here. So right here we have a basin. This is like Death Valley almost. And Lone Pine Volcanic Field is actually up here, Big Pine, Lone Pine, and then this. So let me back this out to show this to you. Right here, Ridgecrest, China Lake. And then as we zoom in here, you're going to see a crescent shape made of volcanoes that goes up to a place called Red Hill and Golden Trout Creek. Golden Trout Creek, well known in the area, it's a small cinder cone, but Red Hill is just another version of it, just older, right next to it. They're two of the same size and shape volcanoes right next to each other. Then we get down here to a place called Templeton Mountain and another place called Monash Mountain. And again, these are two of the same size and shape volcanoes. And then we're on the other side of Brown Mountain. So this makes a crescent shape of volcanoes. Connects over to Soda Butte. Gets its name from effervescence in the water there, bubbling in the water. And then down to the south, one of my viewers pointed this out, it's like a bulging ring laccolith in the mountains itself. And if you take this all together, it makes a giant oval shape, which is bisected by a fault right down the middle of it. Well, if we go up to the north, you're going to see almost the exact same thing right here. Long Valley Caldera, this is a confirmed supervolcano with 1,000 cubic miles of melt down below, 1,000 cubic kilometers of melt, 240 cubic miles of melt down below this. And it's the same size and shape as this. So really, there's two of them. One of them confirmed supervolcano, the other, just I have my suspicions. So the earthquake is coming in right next to it. You could also say it's over next to Lee's Flats. It's on the south side of Big Pine. We're at Lone Pine, and we're just north of Kozo Volcanic Junction. Let's go back over to the USGS plate boundary map and turn on the faults in the plate boundaries. So we're going to actually turn on the smaller faults. And the plate boundary is well known. I've talked about this in many of my previous updates. The thick red lines that go down across California's coast, the San Andreas, for instance, goes up into the Juan de Fuca, and then the thick red line goes up across Alaska and so forth, defining the Pacific Plate. Now, on the inside edge of this, we have a bunch of faults that also go in the same direction, northwest to southeast. You can see they just kind of all go in that same direction. They all lead back up here to Oregon and Washington, all back to the Juan de Fuca fracture zone. So all these faults can be traced in a diagonal line up to here. You can see that they're mimics, but smaller, the actual plate boundary over along the coast on the San Andreas. So a near 6.0 earthquake. At this point, I actually need to go check and see if it's a bigger earthquake than what they're saying. I know there's going to be people that say, oh, well, whatever. We need to go check the stations to see how they're coming to their determination. And, well, again, this is a calculation method, but we're going to go to the local magnitudes here, and we're going to see what the local stations are reporting. If we see a bunch of larger earthquakes reported by all the stations, and they've downgraded it for some reason, I tend to think it's a larger earthquake. How could that many stations be wrong? You know what I mean? So let's just go down the list and see. We're going to throw out the high end, and we're going to throw out the low end. So, for instance, we'll throw out the 5.4s and 5.2s, and we'll also throw out any 6s or upper 5s, like 5.9 or 6.0 that's coming in on the local list. So I'm only seeing as high as 5.9. We'll throw those out. And what does that leave us with? Well, actually leaves us with what they've come to their determination on. It's actually, I would say, an accurate reporting of the magnitude. So it's near 6, 5.8, next to a volcanic field, on a fault that extends to the northwest, pointing back up to the Juan de Fuca fracture zone. But the southern arm of the Juan de Fuca, let's go take a look at that again, on the thick red-lined map, and again, you guys should just bookmark this thing and start using it all the time, the thick red-lined map here. And the Juan de Fuca has been getting charged, and we've been having shifting and vibrating that takes place up here in Washington and Oregon and Northern California. So it's been shifting and vibrating, and ultimately, we go down here, and a 7.4 earthquake struck on the red line to the south. Well, they're directly connected. I mean, you know, again, we're 1,000 miles apart, but the plate boundary is the plate boundary. It's like a road or a river for this seismic energy to travel along. So yesterday, when the 7.4 earthquake struck down here, I issued a warning up here, we issued a warning down here at the Peru-Ecuador border region, and we issued a warning over here at Puerto Rico. So what's hit? What's hit since yesterday? Well, clearly we're talking about the 5.8 up in California, but look who else got hit. 5.1 came in right down here in Ecuador at North Peru's border, and new mid-range, well, you could even say upper 4 because a bunch of other activity struck with this, 4.6. Again, if I'm looking for up to a 5 and a 4.6 comes in or something like that, or an upper 5 and an upper 4 comes in, that's the earthquake we're looking for, at least one of them. So you can check off Puerto Rico. You can check off down here at the Ecuador, well, yeah, Ecuador-Peru border region. And you can check off California. So a lot of people in California didn't know this was coming because they don't know to watch when you get a big earthquake down here, to watch back behind it, down south of it, and out in front of it, or downstream from it is another way to talk about that. And this is just the start. This is day one. It's been about 24 hours since our 7.4 struck down here on the plate boundary. I don't think we're done yet. Now that we've had this happen here, we can certainly expect new 4.0 activity to go across the United States. That includes Texas, West Texas. That includes Oklahoma at the Kansas border region. And it includes far northeast all the way up by New Hampshire and Vermont and Maine, up here on the northeast edge of the North American Craton. So getting back to it, large earthquake has struck in California on top of the large earthquake that struck yesterday morning down here in Mexico. And we go back to the start of the week and we had another 7.4. And that was down here in New Zealand. So two 7.4s, multiple 5s, and of course near 6s. Last night Guam was hit, 5.9. People wrote me from Guam. I've got U.S. military families that are viewers there, thanking me for issuing the warning last week. Now, again, I didn't focus on Guam too much, but they were thinking because they were looking for it and then a new near 6.0 earthquake. Let's just call that a 6. It's a 5.9. Speaking of 5.9s, how about this 5.9 that struck yesterday over in Indonesia? Sure is a lot of 5.9 activity all of a sudden. What would you do if I told you they're all 6s and that they're downgrading them to be 5.9s because they don't want people to be alarmed? What would you do if I told you that? What would you do if I told you the meteorologist didn't want you to be alarmed about the weather, and so they deliberately issued a bad forecast and then go out and tipped out the rain gauge when more rain falls than what they said? What would you call them if they did? What would you call me if I did that? Anyway, so what else has happened? We have another series of earthquakes that struck at our middle point, 4.6, over at Sumatra. Another spread of 4s yesterday going across Asia. We get over here to the Gulf of Aden, new 4.7 last night, and new 4.0 or 4.4 striking to here right next to Greece. As we go out to the west, another 4.6, almost the exact same sized earthquake, following our 6.0 or what was it, 6.3? Let's go see. Well, let's see. USGS has it at a 5.7. Of course, 6.0 level activity in Iceland also. So it's been a busy week, guys. It really has, and I don't think we're done yet. I just told you, 4s are expected to go across the plate over into West Texas, Oklahoma-Kansas border, and all the way up here in the northeast, on the edge of the Craton, up to the northeast. But, as if that wasn't enough, you see where the rings overlap here in Baja, South California. I would warn from just south of the California border, all the way down here to central Baja, for the potential of another large earthquake to strike in the 6-ish range. somewhere in that upper 5 to 6 range. I mean, don't fault me if it comes in at 5.8 or 5.9. Now, for the people out here in Puerto Rico, you know what? I'll go ahead and tell you right now. It's likely on its way. Mid-range 5, upper 5 activity. You already had a mid-range 4. While that is a direct location hit, we're 1 magnitude under expected. So that means there's still energy caught up here down in Mexico. Recapping for anybody who's just joined, a near 6.0 earthquake struck south of the Big Pine volcanic field at Lone Pine. This is north of China Lake and north of Kozo Volcanic Junction. You know what? Let me show this to you too. So 1 year ago, in July of last year, the biggest earthquake in 20 years struck California right here. Shook the whole southern part of the state. We issued a warning 2 days before that, by the way, for a very large earthquake to strike in Southern California. So we got that forecast right last year. Very happy about that. You guys can go back and watch the warning. Again, here I am 2 days before the big 7.0 hit, telling people a larger earthquake is coming, and everybody was talking to me like, you're crazy. They're like, what do you mean? A 6 has already hit here. And I'm like, a bigger earthquake's coming. 2 days later, boom, the biggest earthquake in 20 years hit. Now, I don't think that's going to happen this time. However, we are dealing with significant sized activity, enough that I have to tell the people in Southern California, if the energy is transferring over to the east, which it should, Texas, Oklahoma, Kansas, and up to the northeast, up in Maine, you should also see a transfer down here to the south. Now, I'm thinking south of the border. But if I'm off by 100 miles, it's going to put it right in like San Diego or something, or South LA. So it's a matter of just like 100 miles on an earthquake that can be felt for 200 or 300 miles. Right? 6, somewhere in that range, can be felt for that far in each direction out from the epicenter. 100 miles out one way, 100 miles out in the other, 200 miles spread. So we would want to warn the people now from Southern California to Baja to be on watch for near 6.0 level activity on top of the 4s going across the plate. What more proof do you need? The middle point got hit down here, and the forecast warned point got hit over in Puerto Rico. The only difference is we are 1 magnitude under expected. So if a 4.4 hits up in Puerto Rico instead of a 5.4, that means more energy still trapped here. Same with down here to the south. If a 5.1 hits instead of a 6.1, it means more energy is still trapped here and it should escape out over to the east. Back behind it's just moved. Think of this like a backed up river. Let's go back over to the red line again. Think of this like a river, and the flow is normally going over. It's coming down around and going over. It's also coming across and going over, but it gets blocked right here. Well, we would have a backup then, wouldn't we? All the way back up here. And out in front of it, when it finally releases, it would be like a dam breaking and the water flowing out really quick. So that's why we have the warning going here. And that's why we had the warning going down here. Again, where the plate boundary edges meet is where we issue the warnings. Usually. So recapping, it's been a pretty busy day and a half with the 7.4s and the 5.9s. Come on, multiple 5.9s, 7.4s. And I'll call this a 5.9 too, really. It's a 5.8 plus a bunch of 2s and 3s. Take them all, add them together, obviously. That increases the power coming out of the area. All right, guys. We're going to save this as a quick video. Just because California's been hit, a lot of people wondering what's going on. Let me go back and show you the area one more time that just got struck. The area that just got struck is right here. This is actually like an evaporation pond area, but it's really Death Valley almost. Extreme deserts in Eastern California. We are east of this, which is Golden Trout Creek Volcano. Now, I seem to recall hearing something about Golden Trout Creek Volcano in the past 2 months. I don't know where. I just remember hearing about it. For real, I would have to go look it up right now to go find the story, if it even is out there. Let's go look it up. Hold on. If I can type. And we'll refine the search. Let's just go refine the search for the last month. Let's see if that brings up anything. Well, nope. Well, it must have been more in the past couple months. Again, I don't want to waste too much time looking for it. I just remember hearing something about it. Let's just search. Let's see. 04, 01, or 04, 2020 till today, which is 6/24. showing you guys how to do a search on Google in case you don't know. Does it come up? Maybe it was just somebody talking about it. It's all mixed together up here in my brain. Okay, all right, we're wasting time now. This is a perfect time for me to tell you guys to have an earthquake plan. You know, a day after a 7.4 hits down in Mexico, then a near 6 strikes in California. I mean, I don't know how long we're going to wait for the professionals. I mean, they've missed the boat. So we're going to have to send them another boat. But I'm not going to wait for them to come along and swim along and come up with catch up with our boat and get on board and everything. They've missed the boat. So, I don't know. I don't know what to say about the professionals. But I will tell you guys, you can do what I'm doing here now. An average person, we've got teens and kids doing earthquake forecasting. I've put out the directions, step-by-step directions, how to forecast an earthquake. I did that last year when I got the big earthquake in California, correct? So that was July 4th of 2019. Put out step-by-step directions, how to forecast an earthquake, and I sent it to the professionals. You know what they did? They said they didn't want to know the method. That was Iris. They responded to me in a public tweet. They said, we don't want to know your method. We know there's going to be aftershocks. That's what they said. I go, aftershocks? What are you talking about? Here's step-by-step directions. Please test it. No. We don't want to. But you can. You can go follow the step-by-step directions and start doing your own forecasting. It's not as hard as you might think. And you guys are welcome to go test it and get back to me. Now, one final thing, your emergency kit. Your emergency kit should cover you in a time of disaster, no duh. For earthquakes, you're going to need change clothes, set of shoes, socks, first aid, sanitation, communication, flashlight, batteries, of course. The basics, put into a bag. Have the bag somewhere close by, at least by the door that you're going to go out, or someplace easily accessible so that you can get to it after the earthquake. But you grab it if you're going outside, because you might not be coming back in for a very long amount of time. Now, for the people in California, don't be caught off guard if a large earthquake strikes down here in Southern California going down to Baja. You've got your sandwich. Think of this like a trash compactor where you've got a lot of force on one side and a solid portion on the other, and it's compacting. It's backed up like a dam or a river. So that central point, that fulcrum point between the two, should break and move. And that goes everywhere from Southern California, where the first set of rings overlap, all the way down here to Central Baja. Okay, and the time frame on that should be days. It shouldn't take weeks or months. So we're looking at like this week going into this coming weekend into the start of next week. 7 days. 7 days from today puts us till next Wednesday, basically. Oh man, it's been a wild few days' time. So I'll save this as a video, and we will upload this to YouTube again anytime a near 6 strikes in California. I certainly want to get on and do an update. Let everybody see it, and if anything else goes down, I will be jumping back on at a moment's notice to do a further update. Okay, guys, word up. Peace out.